There are tools that are better than ChatGPT. There are five that I can think of right off the top of my head, so that's what I'm talking about in this video. Stay with me. I'm Phil Pallen, a brand strategist. Welcome to my channel, where I promise practical advice to build your brand. I, like what seems to be everyone on the internet, like them, I'm impressed with ChatGPT. Yes, I am. It can do a lot. And I'm starting to talk more about that on this YouTube channel. However, there are a handful of apps that are still superior to what ChatGPT can do right now. And allow me to explain with our first platform, which tackles copywriting. So let's say I've got an online course, which I do. It's called Content Mastery, and I'm wanting to write a product description for this. So let's attempt to do it in ChatGPT first. I will use GPT-4, the latest model at the time of recording this. And I've often found that the more specific the prompt, the more detailed that you give ChatGPT, the better. So in this case, I'm going to write a product description, and I'm going to use the writing formula PAS for this, which stands for Pain, Agitate, Solve. You may have heard about this. It's a popular one. So now I'll get writing my prompt. Before I click enter, I'll quickly read what I typed. I'm selling a self-paced outline course for professionals wanting to improve their content creation. I need to write a product description for my website, use the PAS formula to write it, and then I write what that is. Step one, pain, outline the reader's problem. Step two, agitate, go deeper into an issue that they are angry or agitated about. Finally, step three, solve. Step in with the solution, which is what I'm selling. Now we'll let ChatGPT do its thing. Okay, so let's look at the final results. So it did follow my instructions, breaking it into steps. So step one, it outlines the pain. Are you a professional struggling to produce engaging, high quality content? And then it goes on. Step two, we understand how frustrating this can be. You spend countless hours pouring your expertise and effort into your work, blah, blah, blah. Step three, solve. This is where our self-paced online course comes in. Designed specifically for professionals like you. Okay, so it's decent. This copy is okay. Certainly, I could have adjusted my prompt to link to the web page. That might have helped, but I'm assuming in this example that I'm starting from scratch. The copy is okay, but it's not changing my life. To me, I read this and it sounds like it's been written by AI. We're already at a moment in time where I can identify that. So I want to show you another tool that I prefer over this. My favorite copywriting tool is Anyword. I've tried all of them. This one I love because it actually scores the performance of your content, which you'll see in action in a moment. Lots of options here to choose from, but I love that this platform built on the same technology, GPT, as ChatGPT, but I just love that it is designed specifically for copy. So I have a few options here. I could select product listing since that's what we're working on, and it gives you a few options. I can also select more and choose PAS, which it's already got set up in here, this writing style. I'll enter the same text and description that I entered on ChatGPT. And obviously, the more text I put here, the more accurate the output will be. But with just one sentence, I can select generate. And there we go. We have a few options to explore. If I want to generate more options, I can. I'll just select this generate button. And there we go, more options to explore. I, for one, like having options to explore here. Maybe I want to take a sentence from here. I could select edit. I could copy this. I could edit right here, or I could save this as a variation and come back to it later on my document. Again, the interface is just really user-friendly to be able to mix and match and pick from the options here to create something awesome. Now, this is just one example of how I use Anyword, but it's worth just hopping in here and trying different writing formulas. They've got blog post topic ideas, video topic ideas, headlines. I often go here to most popular to get some ideas on how I can use this, writing Instagram captions, prompts, even improving your content. And then in certain content types, such as Facebook ads, which it can actually carry over that content there, which is really super handy. This is where you'll start to see that score, that predictive index score, that will actually score my content, and it will give me ideas on ways I can improve it, as well as who it's going to appeal to, main offerings, pains, emotions conveyed, benefits, and a call to action, which is really awesome and a lot more than you're going to get from ChatGPT when it comes to copywriting. Next up, a tool specifically for code. Now, listen, I like to be a jack of all trades, but when it comes to advanced coding, I am not your guy. So instead, I am resurfacing an article that I read that I thought was really interesting, comparing ChatGPT, which we know can help with code, with Bard. This is Google's version of ChatGPT under their brand. Now, this article is by someone who understands code, and they go through in detail different types of coding and debugging. And I'll scroll to the bottom to get the final verdict. They say at the time of writing this, which was back in March, ChatGPT they prefer, but Bard isn't out of the game. And in fact, it came in really handy as a source of a second opinion for different types of research. One concern raised about ChatGPT is that it made stuff up in certain instances instead of saying that it didn't know something, which was definitely misleading in the context of code. I would also emphasize that this was written back in March. Times have changed. Now Bard can actually help you decode and translate into multiple languages. Again, I am not a coder, so I wouldn't even know how to debug code that I was given, but if this is something you do, you might want to get a second opinion, and Bard might be even better for you now. Moving right along, I know you're going to love this next one. You may or may not know that Elon Musk helped found OpenAI, the creator of ChatGPT. However, he's been very openly critical about this platform. In a recent tweet, he said OpenAI was created as an open source nonprofit company to serve as a counterweight to Google, but now it has become a closed source, maximum profit company effectively controlled by Microsoft. Not what I intended at all. So here's his solution. It's called TruthGPT, and Elon Musk is aiming to offer a third solution, or a third alternative, let's say, to ChatGPT or to Google's Bard. But this one is rooted in truth, trying to understand the universe, he was quoted roughly saying. Right now on their website, which I'll link to in the description below, there's information on investing as well as using the app, which is on the App Store, Google Play Store, and via the web app, which I'll give you a preview. It's a lot like ChatGPT if you've played with that. Again, I'm linking to this in the description below so you can try it out for yourself and make the comparison on your own. ChatGPT for knowledge is limited to September 2021 and back. If you are researching current information, you may not get accurate details on ChatGPT. Now, Chatsonic can keep up with recent information because it brings data differently from Google searches. Check this out. Again, positioning itself as a copywriting tool, but very blatantly saying that this addresses the limitations of ChatGPT in this tool called Writesonic. So I think it's really interesting, and their homepage gives a really good overview of what they're focused on. They describe it as Chatsonic wings with GPT-4 powers. So writing factual trending content from Google search instead of from outdated information, only available up until 2021, for example. You can also generate AI art. I'll talk more about that with another tool in a second. Personality avatars, write anywhere and everywhere, voice command your way. So there's definitely some interesting things in here that you might want to check out as you're figuring out which AI tools will be best in your own toolkit. I really like this one, and I like that they're making an effort to make sure that the information represented is as new and as recent as possible. So again, for a copywriting tool, this might be worth it, especially if what you're writing is based on factual information, statistics, or even pulling things from newer articles such as news. One thing ChatGPT can't do much with visuals yet. Okay, that's not necessarily true since it's starting to be able to process images. However, there's a very cool new AI tool that you can try that is all visuals. We've talked about copy, we've talked about code, and now we get to talk about visuals, my favorite. Adobe Firefly is relatively new. At the time of recording this video, it is in beta, but I am in that and I can then show you what some of these features are. So they, at the time of recording this video, have four different ways to try out Firefly. That's text to image, which we'll look at, also text effects, which gives a good example in this preview image, as well as recoloring vectors and impainting. So in this case, you would use a brush to remove objects or paint in new ones from text descriptions. Now, text to image, this is pretty fantastic. Let's actually create something from text to image. I'll just come up with something on the spot, a happy rabbit enjoying the sun. And right away, we can start to see some images that we'll be able to actually modify with settings over here on the side. So if I want to adjust the aspect ratio, even the type of content. So in this case, you're getting art. Let's actually change this to photo. I love how these are looking. Let's try a few more. Let's try graphic. And you get the idea. You can continue to play here with popular settings as well as color and tone. I'm going to select back to the photo option. I absolutely love the output of this. It's incredible that this came from just text. And I know with this tool, it's really just the beginning. I'm going to link to it in the description below. And hopefully if you can get into that beta, you can also have some fun with this. There you go. Handful of apps that just might be better than ChatGPT if you ask me. But I would also love your comments, your thoughts, feedback, etc. Put them in the comments below. We can continue the conversation down there. I respond to those personally. Not fancy enough yet to have someone else do that. If you enjoyed this video, give it a like. That helps other people discover these videos, which I work hard to create for you. And subscribe for more of my videos on branding, positioning, building, and promoting your brand. Next, I'm sharing a few videos that I think you'll be interested in. I'm Phil Pallen. Thank you for watching. Those videos are coming up next. Next.